What's the best piece of advice you ever got?
Learn when to say no. Learn when to say no.
What's the worst piece of advice you ever got?
YOLO, you only live once.
Superpower you wish you had in real life?
I wish I could freeze time.
Freeze time?
Freeze time.
Stop.
Stop time and then move around and do stuff and then come back.
I am literally still trying to process this. Chadwick Boseman passed away today after fighting colon cancer for 4 years. You know, in the midst of all this, I'm trying to wrap my head around this whole thing. I can't help just thinking back to the times where he looked so emaciated and people were making fun of him, and the times where he's on the carpet giving out Wakanda salutes and people are criticizing him for not being enthusiastic about it. And thinking to what we know now, he just looked so exhausted. Gods of Egypt, Civil War, Message to the King, Marshall, Black Panther, Infinity War, Endgame, 21 Bridges, The Five Bloods, and he has another movie coming out later this year, Mulaney's Black Bottom. That man did 10 movies in the span of 4 years while fighting colon cancer. If you, including myself, everything that you're not strong enough to do something, just think, what would Chadwick do?
Hello everyone, welcome again to my channel. Thank you for always tuning in. I really do appreciate you all. To all my new subscribers, thank you so much for tuning in. And to my old subscribers, you all know I feel about you. Thank you so much. Guys, today I was going to do a craft, but that's what I plan to do for you guys today. But of course, when I woke up yesterday with the news of Chadwick Boseman dying, that just changed everything for me. I've not been myself since yesterday. I've cried, I've slept, I've cried again, I've thought about him, in fact I don't even know how to start. I've never met him, I'm not related to him, but the role he played in Black Panther, I think that endeared him to everyone all over the world, especially my community. Yes. And I think the Black Panther in particular, I invested in it emotionally a lot. I took it on, you know, it was relatable for me. It came at the right time for my community. You know, it was just an amazing movie to do at that time. It was apt for that time, and it's still really relevant now, especially with what my community is going through all over the world, especially in America. And the people that are close to me know how much I love Black Panther the movie, and even Boseman himself, the lead role there, who died yesterday morning. I mean, the news broke yesterday morning. So I woke up yesterday, and the first thing my husband told me was that he's got bad news for me. I was like, bad news, what was it again? We've had enough in 2020, what is it again? And he said, Chadwick Boseman is dead, Black Panther. I was like, what? No, that's not true. That's not true. And then I took my phone. My brother, who lives in America, had already sent me a message by 3 a.m. that Black Panther was dead. I was just numb. I just couldn't believe it. How can he die? Why? How? What? You know, all those questions kept coming to me, and yesterday was just a very bad day for me. I couldn't do anything. I was moody. I was crying. I just sat down all day. I slept. I just couldn't do anything. My kids and husband, they were all so nice to me. They understood how I felt. I mean, I've watched Black Panther 7 times. And out of that 7 times, I've watched it 5 times in the cinema and 2 times on the plane. I've not added the fact that I've got it at home and I watch it every now and then with my kids. That's how close, I mean, that is how much I love the Black Panther and even the character itself. People that knows me as well know that. Even my students know that, you know, I love Black Panther. It's so personal to me and, you know, it hurts really, really bad. And I just thought, you know what, I'm not going to do any craft or anything like that today. I'm just going to dedicate this to Chadwick Boseman for all the wonderful work he's done. Whilst down right before, I was going through so much and he was just a superhero, taking fantastic roles that will live with us forever and just pushing on, pushing on, pushing on to the last day. I've got some things written down here that I would like to read to you guys. As much as possible, I won't make it sound as if I'm reading to you, but I think it's very important that, you know, I had to put this down yesterday so that I'll be able to share with you guys. Like I said before, most of the movie is done a biopic. If you take 42, for example, it was a biopic about the first black man to play in a Major League Baseball. Jackie Robinson was a hero of black people back then. And the story told of the adversity he had overcome to break the boundaries. I mean, you can tell that from the roles he picked between those 4 years that he was on, what, 2016 up until 2020, they were fantastic movies. Fantastic movie that speaks to my community, you know. Speaks to everybody, but especially my community. Please, I keep saying my community because, you know, I'm not making it a race thing, but a lot of his roles speaks to us. I mean, like the 42 I just said now, it was the first black man to play in a Major League Baseball. So a lot of this role is taking us, speaks to my community. It encourages us, builds our confidence, and it's just good for my community, you know. Also, Marsha, I've never seen that, but I think I will at some point. But what I've learned is that the story is a true story of Thurgood Marsha, the first black lawyer to be appointed into the Supreme Court in America. I'm sure the theme of overcoming adversity will have played out in this same story, the same way with 42. I mean, look at that. Look at 42. Look at Marsha. The first black this, the first black that. It's just fantastic roles that, you know, my community can look back at and feel proud of our achievements so far. Also, another interesting movie he did is Get On Up, a biopic about James Brown that Chadwick has done again. Now, you all know that James Brown was a famous black musician with a fabulous dancer. I'm trying to hold it all in, guys. I mean, all the three roles in 42, Marsha and the James Brown, they all stood out for me. And I think they stood out for my community as well. The news of his passing away yesterday, like I said earlier, it just broke me and many other people, both black and white. But I think it broke my community especially because he was our superhero. You know, he was able to speak to us through his roles that you can be anything you want to be. And that we can be anything we want to be. He was just 43 when he died. That's quite a young age to die. And he did everything with grace and honor. One of the things I also put down was, when the journey of life ends, the report card of our achievements comes out. Chadwick was an excellent pass. it appears he wanted to portray the heroism of black man's struggle in all his movies, in all his roles. A plot that has become more relevant in today's world, with yet another attempt to achieve a major shift in coupling racism playing out. Ultimately, death at a young age usually stirs emotion. Look at George Floyd and Jacob Blake. They've been made as martyrs. Chadwick's made him a hero. Not just because of the fictional Marvel card, but also because of the spirit we saw in him display despite his battle with colon cancer. We never knew he was fighting something bigger than Thanos in the Avengers. A lot of video clips has been going around, and you could tell from a lot of the interviews and some of the things he said at his interview that he knew he would lose this fight finally. He knew this was going to happen eventually. He knew he was going to die. We all will too someday. We will. And when we do, would we be remembered as heroes as well? How many people will show this kind of love to us when we leave this hurt? Would there be at least one person that would say, oh, this person was fantastic, this person was amazing, this person loved God, this person was good, this person left a wonderful legacy? May our life not be in vain. Thank you, Chadwick, for all the joy you've brought into our lives, all the joy you've brought into our community. Thank you for your inspiration in reality and true fiction. Like you said in Black Panther, I never yielded. I'm not dead. You will live in our hearts forever, Chadwick. You will live in the hearts of many black people. You will live in the hearts of our community. Maybe for a little eternity. Because when we hear or say Wakanda forever, we will remember you. Rest in peace, brother. Rest in peace. Wakanda forever.
Just don't freeze when you see her.
What are you talking about? I never freeze.
When I dare to challenge the system that would relegate us to victims and stereotypes with no clear historical backgrounds, no hopes or talents, when I questioned that method of portrayal, a different path opened up for me. The path to my destiny. When God has something for you, it doesn't matter who stands.